Shadowing is a really good way to learn a language. In the last video, we talked about how to level up your pronunciation. And today, let's do the shadowing practice. While we are doing shadowing exercise, the choice of material is very important. For today and the next 2 days of shadowing practice, I've selected 3 pieces of material. This will also serve as a reference for you when selecting your own materials. The first one, which we'll use today, is a Chinese version of globally best-selling book, Atomic Habits. This book is quite recent, so the language and topics are not too different from our recent lives. Moreover, the book discusses our daily habits, making the vocabulary more relevant and easier for us to use in our real lives. The second piece is a Chinese novel from recent years, written by a contemporary Chinese author and first published in 2005. Like the first book, both the author and the story are relatively close to our real lives. I've heard that some of my students enjoy The Three-Body Problem and have tried reading it in Chinese. Well, Liu Cixin, the author, is quite young and uses modern vocabularies. The events in the books are far removed from our everyday lives. It's an excellent book, of course, but maybe not the best choice if our goal is to learn a language. And the third piece is from my own podcast. This selection will be more conversational and casual. When learning a language, it's helpful to listen to vlogs or podcasts by native speakers because these provide very effective language input. Alright, let's start with today's first piece. I'll read through it once first, and then we can look at the details. If you are new to my channel, good morning, good afternoon, good night, and welcome. I'm Nicole. This is a place for you if you want to learn Chinese easier and quicker. So be sure to subscribe my channel and click the bell, then you will never miss a future Chinese learning videos.
老实说, 我的运动生涯并无任何传奇色彩或历史意义。我始终没能成为职业运动员。然而回顾那几年，我认为我取得了同样罕见的成就。我最大限度地发挥了自身的潜力。老实说,
to be honest, or honestly speaking, 我的运动生涯, this whole part, is a subject. 并无, this is a formal way to say actually don't have. So you also can say 并没有 during your speaking. 并没有, 并 is emphasize, actually really don't have. 任何, also slightly formal way to say any. 并无, this is a verb. 任何, adjective or adverb for the objects. 传奇色彩, 或, 或 is all. In English, 传奇色彩或历史意义. Then when we read them, depends on which part you want to emphasize, you can put the stress on the part you want to emphasize. So which means this sentence, you can read them in different way. 我的运动生涯并无任何传奇色彩或历史意义. This one I emphasized, 并无任何, don't have any. And if I want to emphasize the object, 我的运动生涯并无任何传奇色彩或历史意义. 我, a subject, 始终, from the beginning to the end. To emphasize, this is a whole time from beginning to end. 没能成为, couldn't become, never become. 职业运动员, 运动员, athlete, 职业, professional. So together, professional athlete. If I want to emphasize I never become the professional one, emphasize the professional, then I can read as 我始终没能成为职业运动员. And if I want to emphasize the never, then I can emphasize 始终. 我始终没能成为职业运动员. 回顾, this is a verb, 那几年, those couple of years. 回顾那几年, 我认为, I think, I believe. 我取得了, this is a past tense, 同样罕见的成就, 同样, same, 同样罕见的, 罕见, really, 成就, achievement. So this one can be emphasized. 同样罕见的成就, 我最大限度地发挥了自身的潜力。Now this one, we can emphasize 最大限度的。This one is actually adverb for 发挥 because we wanted to emphasize we already did the best. 我最大限度地发挥了自身的潜力。Another thing during our reading is about neutral tones, the and the. Generally, when we read the or the are really slight because they basically don't have any meaning. They're just functional in the sentence to show the relationship of subject or the verbs and nouns, adjectives. So when we read the and the, we need to slightly blend them into the word they followed.But make sure it's a blending to, it's not merged into, there are still two characters. 我的 instead of 我的 is 我的我的 Really close. 我的 no pause. 我的罕见的罕见的 instead of 罕见的取得了取得了 instead of 取得了 It's kind of like two and a half characters.So you can understand the or the as half character. 罕见的最大限度的自身的 Okay, now let's read them from beginning to the end again.
老实说我的运动生涯并无任何传奇色彩或历史意义。我始终没能成为职业运动员。然而回顾那几年，我认为我取得了同样罕见的成就。我最大限度地发挥了自身的潜力。
In this video, I mentioned how to level up your Chinese pronunciation through initials, finals, and tones. If you prefer learning practical and up-to-date Chinese instead of following a textbook, then you can follow my online courses.I will put the course link in the description below. Okay, I will see you tomorrow for the second shadowing practice. Okay, see you tomorrow.